tend to forget it now, but before the current Honda Civic came out, the compact sedan had been struggling. Critical reviews led to a rush redesign in the early 2010s. In 2015, though, the new Civic arrived, and it ditched its dowdy, uninspiring, cheap character for bold lines, striking colors, and fun design. Now, that car's replacement is here, and it takes a more evolutionary approach to its design. But it's every bit as important for Honda.
Despite the explosion in crossover sales, the Civic remains a popular point of entry into the Honda range. And with the death of the Fit hatchback, it remains the Japanese brand's most affordable product that isn't a crossover. This new Civic will also serve as the backbone of future performance variants like the SI and Type R. So yeah, that's all to say that the arrival of a new generation of Civic is still pretty darn important, be it for first-time shoppers, frugal Honda loyalists, or driving enthusiasts. Few of those consumers will be able to tell this car apart from its predecessor, though. Honda showed plenty of restraint in redesigning the Civic, preferring to smooth out the sharp, edgy lines of the 10th generation car rather than reshape them altogether. The result is a design that's both more conventional and much more anonymous. The headlights lack character, while a weird kink in the otherwise arrow-straight belt lines feels like a flourish for the sake of it. The larger taillights and smoother overall lines near the back of the car do little to help the Civic stand out. The older model took a fair amount of heat for its wild styling, particularly in the Type R guys, but we worry that Honda went too far in the opposite direction with this benign four-door.
Fans of wild and crazy exterior designs might not be huge fans of the new Civic, but they'll adore the new interior. This is a more interesting, more premium feeling place that gets rid of the multi-level design of the old car and replaces it with amazing touches like this honeycomb grille that spans the dash and these new dials, which have like a Mazda 3-like simplicity to them. There's a new 9-inch touchscreen, a 7-inch standard, and an all-digital instrument cluster on range-topping models. But there are other touches in here that we really like. These dials have this knurling to them and they feel very, very premium when you spin them. Same with the physical volume knob. The buttons on the steering wheel are almost Porsche-like in how they feel. They have that solidity that you really look for. The shifter is canted just ever so slightly towards the driver. And as for the seating position, it's excellent. The seats are supportive and comfortable. The steering wheel is just where you want it to be. The sight lines are fantastic. These A-pillars are nice and thin. It is a very, very good interior in here. From a driver's perspective, I can't think of much more that I would want in a compact sedan.
Where Honda made modest changes to the Civic's exterior, it was even more restrained under the hood, carrying over the base naturally aspirated 2-liter 4-cylinder and the turbocharged 1.5-liter from last year's cars. The 2-liter matches last year's output, with 158 horsepower and 138 pound-feet of torque, but it's also more efficient, owing to a new stop-start system and an updated catalytic converter. Also helping matters is the standard continuously variable transmission. As for the 1.5-liter, its 180 horsepower and 177 pound-feet of torque improve on last year's car by 6 horsepower and 15 pound-feet. There are some fuel economy gains for this popular engine, but they're modest, no more than a digit in any single measure. The 2-liter engine is standard on the base LX and mid-range Sport, while the EX and range-chopping Touring receive the Turbo 4.
The 2022 Civic pairs its evolutionary, restrained design with a better, more interesting interior, a more expansive tech suite, and better active safety gear. But there's still a fair amount we don't know about this new sedan yet, including how much it costs. For that, be sure to check MotorOne.com in the coming months. For now, be sure to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube.